I figured I'd make a quick video on how you get one of these apart to get to the back side of the chassis. Now, of course, you take the back cover off first, it's self-explanatory. And then you'll have a screw on each side, right by the vents here. Take that out, and then you have three screws along the bottom. One, two, and this was broken here when I started taking the screw out, so we'll see about gluing that back into place, but that's the third screw, or the fifth, rather. And then we're going to take the plug off the picture tube, and we're going to unplug the yoke. Squeeze the end gently and work it right out. So the anode for the picture tube is free. Alrighty. Okay, you can see that. What's tricky about these, I guess, you really gotta... You see, I've got it laid down on its face. That's what you really have to do with these, because there's no other good way to get the... Basically, what you're doing, the picture tube is attached to the front mask of these Philco sets. 17ers are the same. And basically, we're going to lift the chassis and the metal wraparound body. We're going to lift that straight off of the picture tube, you know, assembly. That's why we unplugged everything. So, inside of here, I forgot about this. You see down there? See the tab? That's how the top of this whole assembly attaches to the cabinet. So we lift up the back, and then as we're lifting, we're going to just come towards the bottom end of the TV a bit, and it comes right out. Alright. You want to be careful. You can see they probably, this thing was probably set down a little too heavy one time, because these are the bottom feet here, and it cracked that off. So I think I have some plastic bonding agent in the toolbox back there. So thought it was interesting that they actually have 19 embossed into the tube envelope, signaling it's a 19-inch. Alright, so I'll set the tube out of the way where it won't get hurt. Let's see, this guy here, this is the bugger that was fizzing on us the other day. See if we can't see. Don't really see any leakage out of it, per se. It was just vanning somewhere. But these already, this is the original Philco can. In fact, these are all the original electrolytics and all in it. And I actually have, I brought home this 17er 3 chassis from storage, because this is very similar to this early Briefcase 19, and this actually has a replacement Sprague 4-section can that's all the correct values. The problem is that the capacitor tester, I've got all the parts that work on it too, but the capacitor tester is out of commission. Both of them that I have, a little guy down there too, and I'm pretty sure I need a new eye tube for this one, which I haven't ordered yet. So without being able to test it and make sure, you know, that it's good, I'm not going to take a chance of putting it in here. Oh, caution. A determined presence of high voltage discharge anode lead to HV cage only. And that warning sticker is right where the hell you can see it. You'd never see it with the picture tube in place. And as we inspect more closely in here, we can see where the soldering iron is burnt through the wires when they were placed or disconnected or reconnected some of these leads. Well, I tried doing, like I've seen in a video, and you can see I've made a disaster of this, prying the old one, the bottom out the old one, and, you know, well, if I could get all this stuff out easily, I mean, I could cobble this back together, that ain't the problem, but, man, this stuff is packed in here, and I don't have a heat gun handy, I don't have a Dremel tool, you know, Shango 66 told me to just cut it along here with an X-Acto knife and glue it back together. Not an X-Acto knife, like a good strong razor. I packed all of that shit away, so unfortunately, I'm kind of limited as to what I'm working with here. And after this, I think that, well, I can't dig this out. I mean, I've got other caps the same size as this or whatever, you know. But I think I'm gonna go find my damn lugs, cause this is too much. This is too much. I could mount a lug, hell, right where the screw is I took out for that clamp. I could just mount a little lug right there and be done with it. So I think that's what I'm gonna do.